So when your users access your web apps, they don't type in your IP address. They put in a name like www.example.net, a web address with a host name in it. The way that your host name gets translated into an IP address is through the domain name system, or DNS. DNS is a worldwide distributed directory of network information. It stores a wide variety of records, but the best known kind of DNS record is the A record, A for address, which maps a name like www.example.net to an IPv4 address. Client programs, such as web browsers, look up these records in order to find the address of a website or another service. As the creator of a website, you need to set up DNS records for it so that users can access it by name. Usually that will involve registering the domain with a registrar and pointing the DNS records at the web server's IP addresses so that users will be able to reach them. A little later in this lesson, you'll have a chance to do exactly that. A DNS turns out to be really important for websites. If your DNS goes down, your site can't be reached by most users. A number of big sites, including Google and Microsoft, have had embarrassing outages caused by their DNS records expiring. DNS domains are also used as part of the security mechanisms for HTTP, including SSL encryption and cookie privacy. The DNS client code, which is called the resolver, is built into every operating system, and programs such as NC or Ping or web browsers can just use it. To test out DNS, we'll use a couple of handy shell utilities called host and dig.